think his advantage is to avoid the tiebreaker.
Yeah, we're really happy to get that last round robin win, and we know that we're into the championship round now, so we're that was the main goal coming into the pool play, was to make sure that we got into the championship round, and avoiding a tiebreaker and being able to sleep in tomorrow is really beneficial for us.
Did you think it would take this long to the final draw to get there?
These things always seem to come down to the wire, and we had a pretty deep pool. I see that, you know, Manitoba's fight for their life out there, and we were doing the same here tonight, and it was a really good challenge for us. We came out, we played really well. That was one of our best games of the week. Obviously, we got some misses out of Nova Scotia, and we took advantage of those misses and capitalized, and really just pleased with how we played here tonight, and bodes well for the playoffs.
Expected to be here a lot quicker than this. I know just one of those weeks for you.
Yeah, things just didn't go well most of the week. Obviously, tough competition, so, you know, getting a lot of what we thought were bad breaks and rubbing guards or just on the wrong side of the inch, right? So just some bad luck, and these teams just pile it onto you when you're not playing well.
This sport can be very humbling sometimes and frustrating, and I know you have high expectations. We've seen good things out of you. Does this take a toll on you?
Yeah, for sure. It was a real grind. It was real hard to stay positive when things aren't going your way, and it keeps getting frustrating, right? So it's tough being out there, but again, you know, put it in perspective that we're here, we're playing some of the top teams in the world, right? So, you know, good end on a win anyway.
And the chance to be out there in front of fans again, I know it's been a long couple of years waiting for that opportunity too. I know Lethbridge really treated you guys well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we didn't play last year because of the bubble and the COVID restrictions and everything. Not just down here, but up in Yellowknife, it would have been about a month off. So, you know, it was a big decision that fans were going to be back, and it's going to be back to a normal Brier experience was, again, why we came back.
And the other positive, obviously, seeing your buddy Glenn get a chance to play in a Brier and get that Purple Heart, that must have been pretty cool for you to see him have that experience.
Yeah, for sure. Again, we're the happiest one we want for Glenn to get here and get to play his brother. It was a pretty special moment for the Kennedy family, so it's fun to be part of that.
Dumb question, but who are you picking in the weekend here?
Oh, yeah. Got to go with Alberta, for sure.
Jamie, do you ever hope to play one of these with your brother someday?
Oh, we'll see, you know, we'll see what happens. But, it would be a dream to play with Kevin as he closes down his career. But, you know, we'll see what happens.
Je viens juste gagner contre Manitoba. C'est une équipe bien forte. Comment sentiez-vous?
Bah, très bien. Toujours le fun de finir le Brier avec une victoire. La bière a goûté mieux au patch après une victoire que défaite. Honnêtement, on est vraiment content de notre semaine. C'est sûr qu'on aurait aimé on a échappé une couple de parties qu'on aurait pas dû échapper, mais c'est ça qui arrive au Brier. Il faut gagner. Mais on est vraiment content, on a bien joué à soir. C'était vraiment une game de fun aussi, avec l'atmosphère, le jeu du soir au Brier. C'est toujours excitant.
Comme vous avez été désigné comme équipe Québec cette année, il n'y avait pas un tournoi provincial. Il y a tellement de talent aux provinces du Québec. Y avait-il de la pression, de la tension supplémentaire avec cette situation?
Ah oui, c'est sûr. C'est une mauvaise situation en partant. Le fait que tu n'as pas joué un provincial pour envoyer une équipe, c'est horrible. On veut jouer une provinciale. On est les premiers à vouloir jouer. Malgré ça, on a fait le mieux qu'on peut avec la situation. Faut qu'on est content d'être au Brier, c'est sûr. C'est une expérience. C'est sûr qu'il y a beaucoup de jeunes équipes au Québec, puis j'ai hâte de les voir dans les années qui suivent. Mais il va falloir nous battre.
Well, Brad, do you think going into this week, have you exceeded your expectations so far?
Yeah, certainly. I shouldn't say certainly. I'm not sure what we expected, to be quite honest. I think the fact that we were coming in here pretty loose meant we could play well, but it could also went the other way pretty easy. Fortunately, you know, we played well. The ice has been really good, so we've gotten a good feel for it. Excited to be on ice that we know where every shot's going to go.
How important is it to miss any pitched line to go home?
It's important. The less games we can play right now, the better. So. I'm pretty pooped after two games today, two long games, tight games. I went back after the first game and slept for over 2 hours, so I'm pretty exhausted.
It's so long. Let me ask you again. Oh, you belong to such a top boy, in my opinion.
exchange logs about the win and so on and so on. And you still run at the table at this moment. How are you feeling about that?
We're excited to get first place. The 8-0 really didn't matter. I think just getting first place was the key, so we didn't have to play that game tomorrow afternoon. Being 8-0 gives us some advantages with Rocks and Hammer going forward, which is nice. You know, that's one thing we didn't have in Beijing was the Hammer very often. So to make sure we have it now in the playoffs, that's a good feature, good bonus.